Around 1900, people talked about the end of physics. The U.S. Patent Office was thinking of closing down because there's nothing more to invent. Then we had twin bombshells of the quantum theory, which opened up the world of the atom, and general relativity, which opened up the universe, black holes, space-time. And then we realized that we were so naive around 1900 to think there was an end of physics. Now today, we ask the same question. Is this all there is? I don't think so, because you see, we have these two great theories, but they don't talk to each other. They don't like each other. They hate each other. Why should nature be schizophrenic? Why should nature create two bizarre theories, one for the big, one for the small, that don't talk to each other? So I think we are bound for a new paradigm shift on that scale, a theory which goes beyond just relativity, a theory which goes beyond the quantum theory. And then, of course, we can ask another question, what happens beyond that?
Well, it would seem that the regress has to end at some point. Some have said that it can go on forever. I conceptually don't see how that's possible. At some point, this has to end.
Well, there's several ways of looking at it. One is the onion theory. You see layer inside layer inside layers, which seems to go on forever. Each time you probe a new energy, you have a new layer of physics. But there's the other theory of the North Pole. The ancient mariners would draw a map without the North Pole. No one had ever visited the North Pole. Well, we've now found the North Pole. There is an end. The Earth is not limitless. I tend to lean more toward the North Pole idea because all the compass needles do point to a theory of everything. And at that point, it would stop.
What can the far future become in terms of possible things that seem impossible today?
Some people say physics stops at the Big Bang. You can't go below the Big Bang because there's nothing there before the Big Bang. Well, we physicists have many models of the pre-Big Bang era. A new generation of machines are coming online which may answer these fabled questions of what happened before Genesis. How will doomsday unfold? Is it possible that there are other universes?
Let's look at the physics of the impossible, things that today seem ludicrous, things that seem to defy all physical law today.
When people say, bah, humbug, that's impossible, what they're really saying is that's impossible with today's technology. But what about 100 years in the future? What about 500 years? What about 1,000? What about 1,000,000 years in the future? Look at invisibility and teleportation, two staples of science fiction. Any physicist would snicker and laugh. Ha! Invisibility, teleportation, beam me up, you know? Well, we've actually done it now. We've actually, on microwave radiation, made objects invisible. And now we're testing it on visible light now for the first time. Also, teleportation. We can teleport individual atoms. Now, extend that maybe 100 years in the future. And then you begin to realize, hey, you know, the stuff that we used to consider science fiction and laugh at, well, that's going to become perhaps the reality of the future.